every now and then you get a great athlete, you know, in a certain sport, we all support them and then we admire them. As a youngster, I was growing up and the first time I seen my name in the paper was really special to me. And then the person who wrote the story about me and ended up writing numerous stories about me, ended up being in my corner, ended up being one of my great friends. And then today, he gets inducted into the Hall of Fame. And then when you think of people who richly deserve things, this guy deserves it more than anybody, because I honestly believe Australian boxing wouldn't be the same without this gentleman. And not only do I believe that he helped me be the person I am and have the following that I had, he's doing the same for another Australian great at the moment by the name of Jeff Horn. And Jeff Horn, I'm sure, will be saying exactly what I'm going to say tonight about this gentleman. And he's the honourable gentleman. He's, I think, the best reporter and the most honest journalist I've ever met, and one of the greatest friends I've ever met. Congratulations, and richly deserved, Bradley Keyser, the induction to the Hall of Fame.
Bradley Keyser has been involved in boxing for almost 40 years. After leaving school, Keyser started his career covering fights for the Brisbane Telegraph in 1979 before moving to Sydney to work for the Courier Mail. When training with Johnny Lewis at the Newtown Police Boys Club, Keyser became an assistant for Lewis at his camp. During his time, he cornered for some of Australia's greatest fighters in Jeff Fenwick, Jeff Hardy, Lovemore Nadeau, and Aussie Joe Buggy. Gradually featured in the corner of every Jeff Fenwick world title victory. A Walkley Award finalist, Grantley wrote a book titled Australian Boxing, the Illustrated History, which in 1998 ultimately became the definitive documentary on Australian boxing, a three-hour masterpiece production titled That's Boxing. Grantley has written books on a variety of subjects, but his love of boxing saw him write the biographies of Australian champions in Jeff Fenwick and Jeff Horn. He was also the writer for Boxing in Australia for the National Library in 2015. He has written for the Daily Telegraph, the Sunday Telegraph and the Courier Mail, as well as being the owner of the Fist magazine and the chief writer for World Boxing for over 20 years. Keyser also currently publishes Australian Boxing Legends. As a journalist, Grantley wrote extensively about world champions in Jeff Fenwick, Jeff Hardy and Jeff Horner. He also travelled with recent challenger Alex Leopold to Germany to cover Leopold's shot at the heavyweight world title. He has also worked behind the microphone calling fights for Sky Television in Australia and New Zealand. In 2017, Keyser won Queensland Sports Journalist of the Year, as well as the Australian Sports Commission Feature Story of the Year for a profile on Jeff Horn. Grantley's career in boxing has covered everything from journalism to commentary to being at the coalface with corner duties. He's covered the sport from all over the world, including Australia, New Zealand, Thailand, Germany, the US, UK, Mexico and South Africa. His dedication to the sport over a long period of time has been extraordinary, and as such, Grantley Keyser has cemented his name in the history of Australian boxing.
Now I started to tear up a little bit when Jeff was speaking before, because I brought back so many happy memories of the great times that we had. You know, I must have written a billion words about boxing over the last 40 or so years, but I was actually quite lost for words when Ray and Brett rang me to say that I was going to the Hall of Fame, because it's just such a phenomenal honour. And thank you very much to Brett and the committee here at the Hall of Fame who do so much work to put this function together and to honour people for, especially the fighters, for their careers that they've had and the people behind the scenes who let the fighters do their stuff. You know, I was walking through the hall just as we came into the big room here before, and to see all those great champions and many of them I've met and interviewed over the years, it's such an honour for me to be inducted, especially since I'm one of the few people in the room who actually wouldn't bruise a drape. So it's just a tremendous thing. And to be inducted on the same night as a great champion like Paul Briggs over there, it really is such a thrill for me. I've had so many messages of support, even Jeff Owen's granddad rang me just before we came down this evening. His Ray Horn is nearly 100 years old. I didn't know he knew how to use a mobile phone, but he gave me a call. And I'm so grateful to everyone that's sent me messages. The two people I really have to thank though for this honour, and I hope I'm not going to go on too long, the two people I've really got to thank is firstly Jeff Fenwick, my great friend, and Ray Wheatley, who's been such a tremendous friend to me over nearly 40 years. You know, Jeff and I were... Jeff and I were both teenagers when we met at the Newtown Police Youth Club. We were both doing some boxing training up there. He was a little bit better at the boxing than I was. As subsequent events showed, he became Australia's absolute super champion. I was telling Colleen on the way over to the function tonight, you know, I used to come down to Melbourne all the time because of Jeff, and he'd win world titles every few months there and pack out the Rod Laver Arena. And the thing with Jeff is that separated him from so many fighters, he didn't win close decisions, he absolutely obliterated the people that he was fighting. I think when he was at his peak, he hardly ever lost a round for several years when he was world champion. So it's a great honour to be in the Hall of Fame with him. And Ray Wheatley over there, has there ever been a better friend to boxing in Australia than Ray Wheatley? He's just done everything in boxing, and he's been such a pal of mine. You know, I had a run in some rather nefarious characters a few years ago, and Ray literally was willing to take a bullet for me. He's that much of a friend. So thank you very much, Ray, for everything you've done for me. Johnny was the guy that got me involved in the corner with Jeff and so many of his champions, and a great trainer and a great mentor for Jeff. He showed people not just left from right, but right from wrong, and he built an enormously successful boxing team. And it was because of Jeff Fenwick that so many champions came to Johnny's gym, people like Costa Zoo and Jeff Hardy followed Jeff Fenwick's success. Two other people I'd really like to acknowledge, and they will be in the Hall of Fame one day, is these two champions over here, Love Moy and Doe, and Sammy King Solomon. A few years ago, I was very lucky to be in the corner when Lovemore fought a guy called Canelo Alvarez, you may have heard of, but the fight was in Veracruz, Mexico. Lovemore at the time was pushing 40 years of age, Canelo was 20. When they got in the ring, honestly, Canelo looked twice Lovemore's size. I thought, boy, this guy is twice as big as Lovemore, but for 12 rounds, Lovemore stayed with him, gave him the fight of his life, and it was just one of the most courageous, big hard performances I've ever seen. So, Lovemore and Doe, it was a good fight. Sammy Solomon, I'd like to just mention, one of the greatest days of my life, I went over to a place in California called Pechanga. Sam Solomon fought a guy who was a very good fighter from Holland called Raymond Javal. It was the best performance of just pure boxing class and skill and trickery I ever saw. He just totally bamboozled Ray Javal for that whole fight. It was one of the best exhibitions of boxing I've ever seen. Sam King Solomon, the former Ray Javal. For all the work that he's done and for coming along tonight. Werner Kalin, the super photographer. Great man, Werner Kalin. Paul and Helen Nazari, who have come along. They do such a great job for boxing up in Sydney. Now I'm very fortunate to come all the way down from Brisbane tonight. Great supporters of boxing. You know, as I say, this has just been a tremendous, tremendous honour. Colleen and I came down from Brisbane on Friday for the awards ceremony, and all the way down, I was thinking just of a line that would sum up the courage of boxing. And for anybody in here who's ever done boxing in any way, sparring or anything, be very proud of what you've achieved, because there was a line Vic Patrick, the great old champion, told me, and it applies to anyone that's ever been involved in boxing. He said, even if you're just a prelim boy, it takes a lot of heart to lace on a glove. So thank you very much, everyone.
Brantley Cooper, ladies and gentlemen. Ladies and gentlemen, we do have two more inductions before we break for main course.
Thank you very much.
Sounds a little bit like this is your wife,
Thank you very much.
Brantley, but I've